Praise the Lord, my dear friends. Thank you for tuning in to another edition of Times of Refreshing. It is indeed a great joy and honor for me to come and share God's word with all of you. Thank you for sending me feedback and your suggestions, as well as your prayer requests. Please continue to send me your prayer requests, or if you have any praise news, please do share with me as well. I want to talk to you today from the life of Simon Peter. Simon Peter thought that he was the wrong person at the wrong time at the wrong place. When he was toiling all night long to catch a fish, but he did not catch anything. But when Jesus got into his boat, his wrong time became the right time. His wrong place became the right place. The wrong person became the rock. I want to tell you today that you are the right person God is calling as well. You are at the right time, at the right place, and you are the right person God is looking for. Are you willing to accept that challenge today? Bible says, steps of a righteous one is ordered by God. It's not a mistake where you are. Yes, you may be thinking that you're experiencing the darkest time of your life. You're going through a valley experience. You're going through great anxiety and fear. But the people whom Jesus chose were ordinary people. Look at Matthew, who was a tax collector, hated by the society. Look at Simon, look at Andrew, look at James and John. They were fishermen whom nobody loved. They were uneducated people. In fact, all 11 of the disciples of Jesus came from Galilee, a region where there were farmers and fishermen. No educated people were there. No universities were there. It was not a religious center. But yet, God Almighty chose the region of Galilee to pick 11 out of the 12 disciples. I want to tell you today that where you are, that is according to the plan of God. So be strengthened. Listen to this message. And may God bless you as you listen to this message. Praise the Lord, my dear wonderful friends. The title of my message is called Wrong Person, Wrong Time, Wrong Place. Are you in the wrong place? Do you think you're the wrong person? Do you think you're at the wrong time? But Bible says that there is no such thing as a wrong person or wrong time or wrong place. Everything, steps of a righteous one, is ordered by God. Yes, maybe you are going through a tribulation or trial in your life. But I want to tell you today that there is no accident in God's sight. Bible says in Luke chapter 5, verse 1 to 10, it talks about an incident where Jesus was being pressed by the crowd. As Jesus was teaching the word of God, crowds were gathering more and more. And then, because of the size of the crowd, Jesus at the Sea of Galilee was standing, and then finally he got into one of the boats. And inside the boat, he started teaching again. It was the boat of Simon. Simon worked hard all night long. He was an expert fisherman. He has been working in the Sea of Galilee probably for a number of years. He knew every corner of the Sea of Galilee. He knew where the fishes would be typically. But that night, Bible says he didn't catch anything. It was a night of sadness, night of depression, a night of labor wasted. Bible says like this, a weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. My dear friend, I don't know what you are going through, but don't lose heart. Don't lose hope. Don't lose faith. There is a morning coming. I speak to some of you who are going through unemployment, financial problems. I read through the messages I receive, and I pray for you, and I feel your pain. But I'm here to tell you today that God has a plan for you. There is no mistake in God's sight. You may be thinking you're the wrong person for God's calling. Maybe you are experiencing wrong time in your life. Or maybe you are at the wrong place. But I want to tell you today, there is no such thing as wrong place, wrong time, wrong person. See, Simon was working hard all night long. All of a sudden, Jesus said this to Simon. In Luke chapter 5, verse 4, it says like this, "He said to Simon, 'Put out into the deep water and let down your nets for a catch.'" It was a wrong time for a fisherman to fish. The fishing usually happens at night when the water is cooler and calm. But during daytime, the water is warmer. The fishes won't come up. And not only that, the fishing happens in the shallow water, not in the deep water. And Simon knew all this. But now all of a sudden, Jesus is asking Simon, "Simon, yes, it is daytime. Yes, the water is deep, but put out your nets. Put out your net for a catch." What was Simon's response? Verse 5, Luke chapter 5, verse 5. It says like this, "Master, we worked hard all night and caught nothing." We worked hard all night. Are you feeling like that, my dear friend? Are you feeling like you worked hard all your life long, but now there's nothing to show off? When you had everything, you had a lot of friends. You had relatives come over. They respected you. They loved you. But now that you don't have anything, nobody is coming over. No friends respect you. You lost your friends. If that's you today, God knows what you are going through. This message is for you. Simon said, "Master, we worked hard all night. I know the every corner of the Sea of Galilee. This is the wrong time. Nobody catches fish during daytime. But nevertheless, I will do as you say." I want to tell you, my dear friend, that whatever the Word of God is saying, follow it. Your life will be a great blessing when you follow the Word of God in your life. Yes, the circumstances may be exactly opposite. The circumstances are against you. Wind and storm is brewing against you. And it's pressing you and pushing you down. Yes, you may be having financial issues. Maybe you're having family issues. You have anxiety and depression. But I want to tell you today, listen to the Word of God. Simon said, "I will do as you say, and I will let the nets down." And then all of a sudden, they had the shock of their life. Yes, Simon has been working hard for all these years. And they never seen this miracle. Miracle of a great catch during daytime when no fisherman catches anything. Historians and theologians say during the time of Jesus, at a given time during the fishing time, there will be about 4,000 boats. There are a lot of boats on that day at the Sea of Galilee. But an unknown man named Simon, Jesus saw him. I want to tell you, Jesus sees you. Wherever you are, Jesus sees you. My dear young friend, Jesus sees you. Older people, Jesus sees you. See, Zacchaeus climbed onto a tree. He wanted to see Jesus. Crowds were pressing Jesus. Zacchaeus didn't think that Jesus saw him. But Jesus saw Zacchaeus. I want to tell you today, even though Jesus spoke, creator of the ends of the world, maintainer of the universe, sustainer of life, provider for billions, he knows who you are. He knows he has a plan for you. Even when you're in your mother's womb, he knew you. He knows who you are. Don't lose courage. Don't lose peace in your life. And Bible says like this, verse 6, Luke chapter 5, verse 6, it says like this, when they had done this, when they heard the word of Jesus and obeyed the word of Jesus, they enclosed a great quantity of fish and their nets began to break. The fish was humongous. Number of fishes came and they caught all these fishes that their nets began to break. Can you imagine this? A person, Simon, who did not catch anything all night, worked all night. But then when Jesus spoke a word, their nets began to break. I want to tell you today, all your life long, maybe you worked hard all your life long, but you didn't catch anything. But there is a time. Book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, verse 1, it says like this, to everything there is a season. If there is a season for weeping, there is a season for joy. There is a season for trouble, there is a season for peace as well. My dear friend, if there is a valley, there is a mountaintop. Yes, many of you are suffering out there. Many of you are going through all kinds of problems. But I want to tell you, I'm here to tell you that the Creator of the ends of the world is with you. You're not the wrong person. Simon thought Simon knew everything. But then when Jesus spoke to Simon, Simon obeyed, his life transformed into Peter. He became a rock. God is calling you to be a rock. God is calling you to be a person of influence in the community that you live in. Jeremiah 29:11, it says like this, I have a plan for you. A plan to give you peace and joy, to give you hope and future. Yes, word of God is true and it will come to pass. Just believe it that today as you listen to this word of God. So don't say the timing is wrong in your life. Everything happened for a reason. Jesus could have gone into another boat, but Jesus did not. There were 4,000 other boats, but Jesus got onto the boat of Simon. And number two, he could have said, Jesus, I am the wrong person. I am not worthy to come into this boat to gather all these blessings. But Peter led him into the boat. And later on, we see when all these fishes started gathering in his net, the blessing was huge. Bible says goodness and mercy will follow you all your life long. Simon's response was, go away from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man. Yes, you may have made mistake in your life as well. But Jesus loves you no matter what, no matter who you are. If you return, if you come back, if you repent in your life, Jesus will still love you. Jesus still cares about you. Our Lord loves you unconditionally, no matter who you are, what denomination you are, what religion you are. Bible says like this, when Simon Peter saw that, he fell down at the feet of Jesus. When you know who God is, worship the true living God. Simon Peter thought he was the wrong person, but Jesus had a plan for Simon's life, to be the rock of the church, to use him in a mighty way. Because of Simon's, Peter's faithfulness, a Christian church started expanding all over the world. He was the leader of the disciples. He became a martyr for the name of Christ. I want to tell you, there is no such thing as wrong person. And then wrong place. Simon said, Jesus, I worked hard all night. I know this place really well. But Jesus knew what he was doing. See, we may be thinking that we are at the wrong place at the wrong time and we're the wrong person. But I'm here to tell you, you are not at the wrong time. You're not the wrong person. You're not at the wrong place. Yes, my dear friend, this message is for you. As you listen to this message, I want you to be encouraged and strengthened. Let the fear go out of you. Fear comes from devil. Peace comes from God. Joy comes from God. Chaos comes from devil. Don't give room to the devil. Don't give room to Satan to cast fear into your life. The one who promised, he will fulfill. At the age of 75, Abraham heard a promise of God that he will have descendants like the stars of the sky, like the dust of the earth. Abraham did not even have one son at that time. Yet, Bible says, Abraham believed God. In spite of the circumstances, in spite of the possibilities, in spite of the condition he is in, at the age of 75, he believed God. He believed God that God, who can raise the dead, will give me a son just like he promised. I want to tell you today that you may be experiencing the darkest time of your life and you may be wondering, will the promise of God be fulfilled in my life? Yes, it will be fulfilled. Just wait for it. Wait for the appointed time. Wait for the vision to be fulfilled. At the age of 99, God Almighty came to Abraham again. Abraham, I will give you. Your descendants will be like the stars of the sky, dust of the earth. Abraham, at the age of 99, still believed God. Sarah was 90 at that time. And Abraham was 100 when the promise was fulfilled. Our God is a promise-keeping God. He never lies. He's a living God. When you pray, he hears. Even when your thoughts, he knows your thoughts. Even when you are sleeping, he knows you. Bible says he knows you from far off. You can move, you can make your bed anywhere in the deepest corners of the world. But he sees who you are. He loves you. This is not the wrong time. Yes. In the midst of Omicron at its highest, I'm here to tell you that this is not the wrong time. This is not the wrong place for you. God has put you in that place where you are for a divine purpose. The Gospel of John, chapter 11, talks about Lazarus, Mary, and Martha, one of the family friends of Jesus. Whenever Jesus would pass by Bethany, Jesus would always stop by the house of Mary, Martha, and Lazarus. Bible says that that village is known as the village of Mary and Martha. That's how that village was known to Jesus and the disciples. But then all of a sudden, a family that Jesus loved so much, Lazarus was sick. Message was reaching Jesus. Bible says Jesus stood there for another 2 days and then went to see Mary and Martha. Thomas said, "No, Jesus, don't go. We cannot go to Judea. They already tried to stone you. This time they will kill you. But I want to tell you, your time is not up until the plan of God is finished in your life. Yes, no disease can kill you until the will of God is done. So why be afraid? There is no reason to be afraid for a child of God. Nothing will happen to you until the will of God is done. Don't have any anxiety in your life. Bible says like this, look at the birds of the air. They do not sow, nor reap, nor they gather into barns. But yet, Heavenly Father takes care of them. How much more does Heavenly Father take care, worry about you, take care of you? That is our God. He cares about you. He will take care of you. He will sustain you. He is our rock. He is our refuge. He is our strength. He is our fortress. Yes, so 4 days pass. Hope for Lazarus is gone. Now they placed Lazarus in the tomb. Lazarus is in the tomb and Jesus was arriving. The response of the sisters were, Jesus, if you would have been here a few days ago, my brother would not have died. Yes, maybe you have placed some things in tomb. You have given up on some things. You have said, no, it's too late. Not even God can help at this time. But I'm telling you, God can help. God will do a miracle in your life. Just believe it with all your heart. Let the peace of God prevail over you rather than the fear from the devil. So Jesus stood and wept with the sisters. With those who cry, Jesus cries. Are you crying today? Jesus sees your cries. Jesus sees your tears. Jesus knows your sorrow. But our God is a miracle working God. Jesus stood in front of the tomb and called out, Lazarus, come out. And the dead Lazarus, who was dead. How did he hear the voice of Jesus? Even the dead will hear the voice of Jesus. Bible says that in the twinkling of an eye, dead in Christ will rise. When they hear the trumpet sound of God, all the dead will rise up. Even the dead will hear the voice of Jesus. Jesus stood and called out Lazarus, and Lazarus came out. No wrong time with Jesus. Yes, you may be thinking it's too late. The sisters said, Jesus, he has been dead for 4 days. His body is stinking now. You cannot open the tomb. The whole community will experience that deep stench. But it does not matter with Jesus. Jesus will do the miracle for you. I'm here to tell you, you are not the wrong person. Yes, you are not at the wrong time or the wrong person or the wrong place. God will sustain you. God will bless you. Just like Simon. Simon listened to the word of God. Even though his human understanding said, I can't catch fish during daytime when the water is warm, when the sunlight is there. Well, I've been working at night, catching the fish at night in the shallow waters. But now Jesus is saying, fish during daytime, go into the deep waters, everything against the human experience and philosophy. Put away your philosophy, put away your thoughts, put away your experience and say, Jesus, here I am. If you do, then God will bless you. No matter what you are going through today, nothing is impossible with God. Nothing is impossible with God. Your disease, Jesus can heal. Your financial problem, Jesus can resolve. Your family problem, Jesus is the Prince of Peace. All you have to do is trust Him with all your heart. He will do a miracle in your life. He will sustain you. He will provide for you. For His name is Jehovah Jireh. May God bless you with this word. I hope and pray that you have been greatly blessed by the message that you have prayed. If you have any prayer requests, please call the prayer line. The numbers are on the screen. If you would like to send me a message, my number is on the screen as well. God bless you. I want to come to an agreement with you and ask God to heal you, to bless you. The Bible says, if two of you agree on earth concerning anything, it will be done. So let's agree that God will bless you. Let's pray. Father, I pray for my dear friend who watches this program. Whatever problems that they are going through right now, I pray that you would touch them in Jesus' name, the name that is above every name. I pray for those who are sick in their body.
Lord, your word says, with your stripes we are healed. We are praying right now for the healing according to your promise, according to your word. In Jesus' name, be healed. I pray for those who are going through family problems. Lord, you are the Prince of Peace. I pray that you would touch them and rebuke every spirit of division, every attack of the enemy in Jesus' mighty name. I pray for those who are financially struggling. Lord, I pray that you would bless them, for you are the provider. You are the Jehovah Jireh. Thank you, Lord God, for answering all our prayers. I bless each and everyone who listen to this program. Let your name be glorified and exalted. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Well, God bless you. Until I see you next week, may God's presence be with you.